DDL and DML. DDL is data definition language. Data definition language. Whereas DML is data manipulation language. Data manipulation language. First one, DDL. So you are going to define the data by a set of definitions. Here we use some definitions or standards. So what is the database schema? Yesterday we discussed it. It is the overall structure or design of a database. So in order to define the overall structure or the design of a database, you use some definition. So such type of language is DDL. So some commands we will be using. For example, create, alter, drop. These are some examples. Suppose I am using a create command. So what create command is used? To create a table. That is, to create a table, you will enter some data inside the database. So create a table, you use create command. So whenever you need to alter data inside the table, then you use alter command. Whenever you want to delete the table, then you use drop command. Delete table or view. This is used to create a table, this is used to modify the table, and this is used to delete the table. These are the DDL use. That is, we are going to use some commands. The next one is DML, data manipulation language. So whenever you need to access the data that is present inside the database, that time you go for DML. So access the data, in other words, you can tell it as you are going to retrieve the data. So it is used for retrieval. Suppose you want to manipulate, that is, you want to insert some new data, you can do by DML. Suppose you want to delete some new data also, you can do it. Suppose you want to modify something also, you can use DML also. So insertion, deletion and modification. Insertion, deletion as well as modification. DML available. One is procedural DML. Another one is declarative DML. Procedural DML and declarative DML. So whenever you are using procedural DML, the user should specify what data he or she wants and how the data you are going to get it. All the things you should specify in the query itself. The user should specify what data he wants and how to get the data. All the things you should specify. Whereas in declarative DML, we specify only what data he wants around. So in database language, there are two types, DDL and DML. DDL is data definition language, DML is data manipulation language. In DDL, vague users or unsophisticated users. In simple terms, they are not having any knowledge about the database. No knowledge about database. So no knowledge about database in the sense they will not have any technical skills. So no technical skills will be available for the snake users. No technical skills. But they are able to operate the system, they are able to work on several applications present inside the system. For example, we can tell that system. Suppose we are not aware of the SQL or any database query language, we are able to operate the system right. So we are an example for snake users. So snake users can operate application programs alone. They are aware of application programs alone and they will use that application programs alone. For example, if you are going to an ATM, what you will do? ATM machine, you will go and insert the card, you will get the money. Only that part you will know. Instead, what is happening at the back end and all, we will not know, right? So that is an example for main users. They will know only the outer part alone. Inside what is happening inside the database, they will not know. The second one is application programmers. Application programmers are also called as software developers. So they have a complete knowledge about the database. So software developers are also called as computer professionals. They have a complete knowledge about the database. They are also called as computer professionals. So these computer professionals are able to develop certain applications. They are aware of all the things, so they will be able to develop certain applications. So how they will develop it? Using some tools. So that is referred to as application development tools. Application development tools. Using the tools, they are going to develop something. So what is UI? User interface. So using user interface, they are going to develop some application and they are going to use it. So they are aware of user application, they are aware of applications, they are going to develop something. The next one is, they are going to develop applications, right? We have discussed about RAD model in the previous section itself. So what is RAD? Rapid application development. So why we are going for this rapid application development? You are going to develop the application in a faster pace. You will develop it in the short duration. So they will use rapid application development tools and they will create the applications. Rapid application development tools they are using. Rapid application development tools. Data analysis software. query language also. So data analysis software also can develop. Data analysis software. The last one, specialized users. They are having some extra knowledge. Suppose you are having some multimedia data also. They know how to work on the multimedia data, normal database, everything they know. So such type of persons are specialized users. Even if you are giving some other form of data, that is multimedia data also, they are able to work on. An example is, what is CAD? They will give us some drawings and all that. So such types of users are referred to as sophisticated users. So they are going to create some design. So computer aided design system they are going to create. Computer aided design system. So the specialized user is having a knowledge, overall knowledge of everything. So they are creating a knowledge and expert system also. Knowledge and expert system. So the specialized user will have overall knowledge of everything. So they are creating knowledge and expert system. Knowledge and expert system. So that's all. Database user, there are four types. First one, native users, they not have any knowledge. Just they know how to operate the system. They are called as native users. Second one, application programmers are software developers. They know a particular part alone, they know some coding part alone, they do that alone. And sophisticated user is they know query language. They work on the queries and they will access the database. Specialized users are the ones who know everything. Knowledge about everything and they are expert systems. Next topic, data model.
Physical level.
In logic fuel level. What data stored is large fuel level. And the third one, fuel level. The accessing ability of the people, that is the fuel level. So in this three levels, how the database is designed, that is referred to as data model. So the design of the database at three levels. Database at physical level, logical level, as well as view level. That whole concept is referred to as data model.
Conceptual simplicity.
also you can take it as a disadvantage. Knowledge about the query language. The next one, second model, ER model.
Communication tool. Easy to understand, so it is an effective communication tool.
designing some database, then draw like this one diagram, then see the features. After that, they will do for the query part. So this is easy to convert to another models. Easy conversion to another models. Object-oriented model, it is referred as object-relational data model. Object possible. So since you are combining two models, it is having improved performance comparing to other models. Improved performance. So what will be the disadvantage of choosing this model? So you should know both the models. You should be aware of object-oriented concepts as well as you should be aware of this relational model or VR model. So you should have proper knowledge. That is one of the disadvantages. Another one, you are combining two or more things, it is becoming complex. If it is one model, it is simple. If you are combining two or three, it is complex. So these are the disadvantages. One is you should have knowledge. Another one, it is complex. So these are the disadvantages of using this object-based data model. The last one, semi-structured data model. Fourth one, semi-structured data model. Semi-structured data model. Suppose there are two application programs, any programs, two separate applications are there. When they want to transfer something from the database, at that time they use the semi-structured data model. When two different application programs wants to transfer or get some data from the database, then they will go for this semi-structured data model. Data model. So here in semi-structured data model, they will be using XML. So what is XML? Extensible Markup Language. That language they will be using here. Extensible Markup Language. Fourth one, between application programs.